What is up guys, Sol, I'm here back again with another classic WoW Season of Mastery video. So exactly how popular is Season of Mastery, and how popular is your server? Today we're gonna check out these questions and I'll try to give my opinion on it, and we actually have an addon that can help us as well to answer these questions. So throughout this video we will find out a little bit more about exactly how popular Season of Mastery is, at least on the two servers that I'm playing on, where I can gather data for my servers, and you can even use the addon yourself to gather data for your server as well, to find out exactly how popular it is, as well as which levels people are, which classes are the most popular, which factions or which races are the most popular as well, so you can find out a lot of different information using this addon. So let's just get straight into it. The addon I'm talking about is called CensusPlus, and it will pretty much scan the WHO list on your server, and you don't have to do anything, you can just download the addon itself, leave it up in the background, and it will scan the WHO list on your server in the background while you just play the game, and after an hour or two, it will have finished the scan and tell you all about your server. So personally, I'm playing on both Dreadnought and King's Fall on Europe, and I've done scans on both of these servers, so let's just check them out. So my main server is the King's Fall server, which is a PvE server. I recently did a scan on a Friday night, roughly around midnight. I pretty much started the scan at 11 PM, it's now 12:53, and we have finished the scan. So after doing the scan itself, you will see how many people there are in total. So for example, right now there's 5,036 people that are currently online at the time of doing this scan. So if you want the most accurate result, you want to do different scans throughout the week at different times throughout the week as well, to get the most accurate results. Based on this scan, we can see that 535 people, which equals to 10.62%, are level 60, and you will also see that roughly 1 to 1.5% are in the levels 50 to 60 as well. So if we add up, or level 50 to 59, so if we add up level 50 to 60, that's roughly about 25% of the entire population being level 50 plus. You will also see a lot of people, anywhere between 2% to 3%, all the way down to roughly level 25 or 30. So there's a lot of people spread out at a lot of different levels on my server, which tells me that people are leveling in their own pace, and it's not like people are rushing to max level, because you're still seeing a lot of people in level 25, 26, 27, and down to 22 as well. Once you go lower than level 20, you will see the percentages start to drop off, and at level 10 you have 0.4%, so you have a lot less people, but you will find a healthy amount of people in pretty much all level brackets on my server. You can also see that the most popular class on my server is the warrior class, the second most popular is a mage, the third most popular is a hunter, and the fourth one is a rogue, and then we have paladin, priest, warlock, and druid in that order. The most popular race is human, second most popular is night elf, then gnome, and then dwarf. Human is the most popular by far, and then night elf, gnome, and dwarf are pretty much the same. I have done a similar scan on Dreadnought as well, which is a PvP server and the most popular server for Europe. So over here you will see that the results are completely different in pretty much every aspect. So on this server, a lot of people are level 60. You will see a huge spike in level 60s, and then you will see a lot of people under level 30, and then from level 30 to 40 or 50, you will see like medium amount of people, then from level 50 plus you will see a lot more people, and then level 60 you have a huge spike. So at level 35 we have 1.5% of the population, and then it slowly climbs up in percentages from there, and at level 50 you're looking at 3% of the player base per level, so between 2 and 3% all the way to 59, and then at level 60 you have 24.49% of the population. So if we go back to my previous server, we had 10 point something percent, here we have 24.5%. Almost 1/4 of the player base are level 60 on this server, and you will also see there's a total of 7,923 characters in total during this scan. Now this scan was done on a Saturday at 11:28, So we started this scan at 10 p.m. and we finished the scan at 11:28, so right before midnight on a Saturday. And I think a lot of people are playing on Friday evenings and Saturday evenings, so we are getting to scan a lot of people. Another change we are seeing from the previous server to this one is that on my previous server, my main server, the most popular class was a warrior, while for this one we have rogue, warrior and mage really close to each other, while rogue is number 1, warrior is number 2, actually no, we're rogue number 1, mage number 2, warrior number 3, then we have hunter, priest, paladin, warlock and then druid. So for both servers, druids are the least played, warlock is the second least, which is actually surprising, but rogue being number 1 on a PvP server actually makes sense, because rogues are a little bit more attractive on PvP servers than PvE servers, because, well, PvP in the open world, rogues are absolute king. Both for offense and defense, rogues are fantastic. We can also see that there's a lot of humans once again, but we can also see that there's a lot more gnomes, dwarves, and night elves in comparison on this server, while on the PvE server called King's Fall, we had a huge amount of humans, and then very low on the other races. This time around it's a lot more balanced. This is actually really useful information, because whenever you're logging on to Classic WoW right now or Season of Mastery, whenever you're picking a realm, it will tell you if it's a low, medium, high, or full population realm, but it won't tell you exactly how many people are playing on each faction. But using CensusPlus, which is the name of the addon we're using right here, which you can download as well, so I would recommend you download CensusPlus. And if you're playing on North America, I'm especially interested in checking out your results, so feel free to do a scan and let me know on Discord. My Discord server is linked in the description down below, so send me the image of your census scan so I can check it out. So it is really useful to know, because this way you can see exactly how many people are online at different times throughout the week, and you can also see which people are which in which level brackets. So if you're, for example, level 30 right now, you can see how many other people are in your level bracket on your server to find out how many people you can group up with, and what the chances are of you finding a dungeon group to do dungeons with while leveling. So yeah, there's actually a lot more people playing Season of Mastery than I thought it was, even though I'm playing the game every single day and I'm seeing the chat, the world chat and trade chat going absolutely ham. The fact is that Classic WoW is such a huge game, and there's so many zones in the game itself, so you never actually get to feel how many people are currently online, unless you use a tool like this that will literally tell you exactly how many people there are in the open world right now by scanning literally every single zone and every single level bracket. So that is pretty much it, guys. I just wanted to talk about the health of Season of Mastery and the population itself for pretty much the service that I'm playing on, and also just how popular Season of Mastery really is, because it is quite popular. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like down below, subscribe for more Classic WoW content. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon.